The contestants of The Voice continues to wow the crowd inside the Performing Arts Center as the groups narrowed down to 12.
Plus, you voted them in. The basketball homecoming winners are crowned in front of a large crowd. I'm Haley Karanogan.
And I'm Maddie Hayes. Another season of Mustang TV News starts right now. Spring homecoming concluded this past weekend with the pep rally, the dance, and the crowning of our king and queen.
Your king and queen winners are Cameron McDowell and Isabella Miller. The basketball game was last Friday, with both boys and girls winning in a doubleheader against Graves. The Lady Mustangs won 37-19, while the boys won 44-35. The coronation also took place during the game, crowning Cameron and Isabella king and queen. Cameron said that he loved the experience, but winning wasn't his favorite part.
Favorite part was probably going out and doing a little dance for Pitbull Fireball at the pep rally. It's pretty fun.
The homecoming dance was held last Saturday. Prom will be on May 4th.
For the first time at MCHS, the Student Government Association is hosting our own Dance Blue Mini Marathon. Dance Blue is a 24-hour dancing marathon started by the University of Kentucky. The dance will be on February 17th with a $25 registration fee that comes with free food and a t-shirt. There will be a 5-hour dance mini marathon, games, and a 30-plus UK students teaching the Dance Blue line dance. SGA Vice President Addie Dover played a key part in organizing this event.
The money that was raised goes towards the Golden Matrix Fund, which helps kids with pediatric cancer at the hospital in Lexington. And so it's just a really amazing event that helps kids with cancer and raise money. It's really fun.
Interested in signing up or donating? Scan the QR codes and flyers around the school. The 2024-25 school year is coming up fast, and the first step to prepare the underclassmen is scheduling. Counselors and assistant principals have started calling students down to go over their class schedule for next year. The one-on-one appointments start with juniors and go alphabetically. Students are free to go in any house office and pick up an extra form if needed. However, with the extra class period being added next school year, there will be 6 year-round classes and one that switches with the semester. So keep that in mind when deciding your classes for next year. If you have any questions about your schedule, you can always email your house counselor or principal.
Main Stage School of Performing Arts is putting on their production of Seussical the Musical. Several MCHS students are involved. Students of Main Stage have been rehearsing since November. After many dance and vocal rehearsals, plus work days for the set, the cast is ready to show the community what they have dedicated so much time to. Show days are February 1st through 4th and 9th through 11th, with an additional show Tuesday, February 13th for special needs students. Jack Nelson plays Horton the Elephant and tells us about his rehearsal experience.
It's been a long one. It's been long and it takes up a lot of energy, but still it's been very fun because I'm with the people I love.
There's only one show day left for tickets on February 10th at 1 p.m. Get them while you can on MainStageSchoolOfPerformingArts.com.
Aren't you in the Seussical?
Yes, I am. I'm JoJo. Are you coming to see it?
I am coming to see it.
When?
Saturday.
MCHS Varsity Girls and Advanced Treble Chorus were selected for a performance review in Louisville by KMEA, followed by an all-state concert. Last year, the women's choir got selected to perform for KMEA. KMEA is the Kentucky Music Educators Association, which runs the all-state choir as well as the performance review. Emily Schley is participating in both, and she says she feels honored to be involved.
I'm going because I love choir and I love singing, and to be mentioned and honored as one of the best singers in the state and one of the best in one of the best choirs in the state is just a really awesome honor and really amazing.
They will be performing at Louisville's Cathedral of Assumption on Thursday, February 8th.
The MCHS Theater Department recently started rehearsals for the spring musical. This March, the theater department will be performing The Addams Family for 3 nights only on March 21st, 22nd, and 23rd. Tickets go on sale at the end of February. The cast is very excited to start this show strong in rehearsals. Ethan Brown is preparing to play as Gomez Addams.
Build character within yourself, offstage as well as onstage. Very interesting spins on it. I mean, the show itself is just wonderful, amazing music, fun choreography. To work with the most incredible cast I've ever known is also a huge plus for me.
Many students are helping with set design and building. You can find more updates about the Addams Family on the McCracken Theater Department's website along with their Instagram. 10 contestants moved into the second round of The Voice McCracken. The coaches eliminated 7 singers as the first round of eliminations began last week in the auditorium. The judges also decided to save 2 more. Host and last year's winner Braden French agrees that freshman Carson Chestnut has surprised everyone with his performance.
He's awesome. Dude just walks up on stage, got the mic in your hand. I don't think anyone expected that, what he did.
The next round of The Voice will be on February 16th, with the next round's genre being Top 40s music.
The girls' bowling team will soon compete in the state tournament. I'm Zach Pote with Mustang TV Sports. The girls placed second in the region to move on to the state tournament in February. Sophomore Ella DeHart called second place a big accomplishment and now says the team is still working through some things.
We're just trying to get all of our emotions together and work on our weak points, and then I think we should be good at state.
On the boys' side, senior Ross Ramage once again is the best bowler in Region 1. He will also move on to the state bowling championship. The boys and girls basketball teams continue to win as their seasons continue. The boys team is 17-5 on the season with wins against both Paducah Tillman and Graves County. The girls have also dominated, defeating Tillman, Graves, and undefeated Delta, Missouri. They both play Tillman tonight inside Strawberry Hills Arena. The girls start at 6 with the boys to follow. The swim team has had a great season so far. The girls team is placed in the top 3 at every meet they have been to. Congrats to Caleb Suter for winning both of his 100 individual medley and 50 fly at the swim team's last meet they went to. Caleb Suter is a senior this year and will be leaving the McCracken swim team along with Corbin Knight and Dylan Wunsch. We wish the swim team good luck at regionals on February 9th. The chess team recently placed second in the Scholastic Tournament. MCA Chess placed second out of 4 teams, Livingston County, Paducah Tillman, and Murray. It was at Murray Middle School. Saw Hines placed second in the whole tournament with 3 points.
I think I did better than usual. It was a bunch of close games really, but I pulled through, I guess.
Next Saturday, the chess team competes in the Quad A tournament at Livingston High School. With nationals right around the corner, McCracken County High School co-ed team travels to Orlando to compete for a national title for the 7th time. Our co-ed cheer team has many titles in the past couple years, 5 state and 6 national. They won a bid this year at KHSAA's state competition in December that allows them to compete this year at Disney World. Riley McKenzie has been involved with co-ed for 3 years now. She has been on mat since her freshman year, making her eligible to perform at Disney. They will leave on February the 8th and perform that Saturday on the 10th. You can watch with a subscription to Varsity TV. 3 McCracken wrestlers now have 100 wins in their career. The team cheered when James Berrigan, Hunter Hawthorne, and then Frankie Nunt reached the goal. James was the first to reach the century mark, saying he was not only happy for himself, but the entire team.
Satisfying, finally. My dad told me that this season I will broke 100. He didn't want to tell me when. So I was just waiting. My teammate Hunter got it just the day before me, and so I was just happy to be able to finally get it over with. That's what I was working for this whole season. Really, that was my first primary goal, was to get 100 wins first.
James and the wrestling team went to state last weekend. They placed 7th overall.
I'm Dr. Professor. Studied at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology.
I'm still Dr. Professor.
Graduated with a doctorate in Ripley.
And I still study at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology.
Everywhere, freaks and fairies, dykes and fairies, tell me where it's empty. Tax the rich. Feed the poor till there are never rich no more.
Oh, Guess who's back?
Back again. Shady's back.
Thanks for watching the first episode of the new season of Mustang TV News.
You can find previous episodes and our morning announcements on the YouTube channel.
And remember, everyone matters.
And every moment counts.